Matt, how are you feeling this morning, man? Beautiful morning, a little crisp, but what's kind of run through your mind this
beautiful
morning?
Beautiful morning. Great day to go fishing, that's for sure. When you can see your breath. You can see your breath, and the bass live in less than 5 feet of water. It's really not ideal conditions, but maybe a couple will bite today. We never know. All right, guys. Heading out day number two with the hammer trap rigged up. I'm excited to get out there, see if we can't reel a few in. Another cold morning. We've got to catch a few fish here today to make that knockout round. So we're looking to catch a few early and then hopefully kind of expand on our areas. I don't know. I'm excited to get out there and put the old hammer trap to work.
All right, Mac, tell me what's going to run through your mind right now.
Junior!
Well, day two's getting kicked off.
Sitting at 12, it's going to be Jacob Wall.
And we're going to try and catch a couple bass today. We're sitting in the lead. That's always a good place to be. And we need to catch a few to stay inside that knockout round. That's the main goal today, stay in that top 10. We don't have to win today, but we got to stay in that top 10. Weight zero heading into the weekend. So we're going to go back to where we caught a few the first morning and kind of see how things go and kind of just adjust from there. You know, it's springtime. Things are changing every day. The weather's warming up, cooling down, warming up, cooling down. The fish are moving everywhere. So we got changing conditions. It's just going to be a matter of who can stay on top of it, make the right adjustments heading into the weekend. That's the guy who's going to be on top.
In any time, Matt.
Lines are in?
Yep.
We're allowed to work, huh?
Yes, sir.
Get to work is what you're telling me.
Yep, get to work. That's your cue. I'm telling you, man, them seats are ridiculous.
You like that, huh?
God knows. I've always been a ranger, man. You're going to convert me.
What do we have here? Look at that thing. That is what you call a meatball. Meatball. Okay, there's still bass here.
3 pounds, 14 ounces.
314 to start the day. That's what you call a meatball. Look at that belly. Big pre-spawn female right there. I guess that's not even a big one. Let's do that again.
Come on, baby. 25 seconds.
Buzzer beater. Oh, buzzer beater. I love me a good buzzer beater. You good?
Yep.
Okay.
2 pounds, 10 ounces.
210 to start the break. That's what I like. Thank you for biting. Thank you, thank you.
End of period one.
Yep, now it's snack time. That was good. We got my 2 per period and it took it down to 15 seconds left, but that's fine. That's all that matters. That's all that matters. Before the period break, we're in. And now it's break time.
We ready.
That's a nice fish. Thank you, Lord.
Three pounds, 8 ounces.
3.8. Yeah, that's a nice one. Meatball. Meatball. Best part, we get to let them go.
Pounds, 1 ounce, 2 pounder.
My second this period went on pace to what I wanted. That's good. We're just fishing some new water. I like
Matt, are these fish relating to anything in particular out here, or what are you kind of trying to target, if anything?
I'm just looking for a little bit deeper water out here. So that's, you know, we came here, Fancy Cooper is a shallow water fishery. Like, these bass live shallow, it seems, to me anyway. And, you know, we had these cold nights, and I just could not get over fishing 2 foot of water with 30 degrees out, so. I started looking for stuff in just a little bit deeper water, more of that, say, 4 to 6 feet range, just because I feel like that water won't be as affected by the cold nights. And it's 3 times as deep if you're looking at 2 foot to 6 foot, so it's just a little more protection for them, you know, a little bit deeper water, the temperature doesn't change as much with the cold nights, and then the hydrilla. So it looks like
when the lake drops out for the winter, a lot of these shallow areas will be dry land because the grass doesn't really grow on the shallow stuff. It grows in this a little bit deeper stuff. So it, I would say it starts around 2 feet and grows out to about 6 or 7. But anything shallower than 2 feet, there's not really any eelgrass or hydrilla. And I assume that's because that's usually dry land, you know, throughout the winter or whatever, and kills all the grass up there. So a couple reasons that I'm looking for that little bit deeper water. And you know, just typical tree spawn stuff. Like if you look around us, there's endless targets for a bass to spawn on everywhere we go. We're very close to, you know, backwater ponds where there is tons of spawning habitat, and those fish are going to be there soon. But we're just a little early for that, so I've been looking for them where they're staging. Close to where they're going to spawn, but they're not quite there yet. You see that?
Yeah. A lot of grill suckers.
Oh, that's a bass. One bass, look in. Bite it. Just bite it.
You know he's close when you see that bait.
Yep, the bass. That is a bass. That is what we wanted to see. They are bass here. You have to pull out some tricks to get one to bite. But I knew they were bass. Whew. 2 pounds even. 2 pounder. Just a little guy, 2 pounder, but that is a new spot, a new area, and there is a lot of them around here. That's good. I don't know why they're so hard to get to bite. They're in really shallow brush piles. So it's the exact same scenario that I've been fishing, the same kind of pattern, I guess, but these are brush instead of grass. So there's little just brush piles put here out in front of this big spawning bay right behind us. And they're just sitting in there. I mean, you can see it all over the screen. So that's the first bass I've caught on LiveScope this week. I have not looked at them all week, but that's the first one I caught looking at. And there's some more in there. I've been throwing at these fish for a while. I've thrown everything. Drop shot, the Miki, Nico, jig, jerk bait. He was just looking at it really close. Sorry, buddy. Thank you for biting. Boys, we found some more bass. This is good.
Ready.
This is good.
£3.5.
This is good. 3.5. Little meatball. And we found some more bass. That is a meatball there. Yes, sir. That's a big one. Tell me something good.
6 pounds, 4 ounces.
6'4". Oh, beautiful fish. Unbelievable. Thank you for biting.
Put together here?
That was the, we're a couple of feet from where I got a bite in practice, and the big giant hydrilla flap. I guess it's not all hydrilla, a lot of it's eelgrass, but right here there's some hydrilla. Got a bite in practice, caught about a 2-pounder here. So I think if we come give it a few minutes here today and see if maybe there's some more fish around. Forget what you told me I needed.
It's close. It's close.
I think you said 6'8".
Yeah.
Regardless, that's a nice fish.
Yes, it was. Well, we would have been all over him, but he's caught another one.
Dang.
He just caught a 207, but we're 2 pounds, 12 ounces back. That's a good fish. Dylan Hayes.
Dylan Hayes.
Alton Jones made a run right there toward the end. He got back up third. 66 pounds.
Well, Matt, can you just give me your thoughts on the day?
Yeah, man, we had a good day. We caught a few fish. We expanded on our areas. That was the goal today, was find a couple more areas. And we did that. You know, we only fished one spot where I caught a fish the first day on Tuesday. And we caught one there, but I found some new areas, kind of a new pattern even. So I'm excited about that heading into the knockout round. I don't know what's going to happen. You never know. It's fishing, but I feel like I'm going to put my bait in front of a few bass on Saturday, and if they bite, we're going to reel them in. So that's about all we got. It's a great day, and heading to the knockout round. Decent day of fishing.
Hey, they beat you, reeled them in.
That's exactly right. Every time one bites, you reel them in.
Yep.
It's as simple as that.